Hi everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to create a custom Windows installation package that already includes pre-installed software. First, you need to prepare the VMware Workstation Pro software for me. Secondly, you'll need the Windows 11 ISO installation package, and I'll guide you on how to download it. Type the keyword Windows 11 and go to Microsoft's official homepage. Here, select Download, then choose the ISO file option. Since I already have the file, I won't download it again. Next, get ready the software applications you want to install. These are the software applications I've already prepared for installation. Now, open VMware and start the process. Create a new virtual machine. Here, select Custom. Select I will install the operating system later. Select the installation version as Windows 11. Here, set a password for this virtual machine. I'll use the numbers from 1 to 8 to make it easy to remember. Select UEFI. I'll set the CPU configuration to 2 cores with 2 threads. Set the RAM to more than 4 GB. You can choose either NAT or Bridge. Set the hard drive type to SATA or NVMe. Set the virtual hard disk capacity to 90 GB as recommended. Now, go to Edit Virtual Machine Settings, and in the CD/DVD, SATA, section, choose Use ISO Image File. Then browse to the Windows 11 ISO file you downloaded earlier and select it to connect. Press any key to boot into the Windows 11 installer. You can choose any version of Windows 11 to customize according to your needs, such as Home, Education, or Pro. As for me, I've chosen Windows 11 Pro, so I'll continue with that edition for installation. So Windows has been installed. To quickly create a local account, press Shift and F10 on the keyboard. And then enter the command on the screen. Now you just need to enter the name and it's done. So now you're inside Windows. Move your mouse up, select the VM tab, and install VMware Tools. At this point, go to your D drive to install it. After finishing the installation, restart the computer. Now move your mouse up. Select the VM tab, and then choose Settings. Switch to the Options tab. Go to the Shared Folders section and check Always Enabled. Click Add and select the folder where you have prepared the software for installation. You can name it anything you like. Make sure the Enable This Share box is checked. Now open File Explorer. Open the Network tab. Click on the yellow text and select Turn On. Now switch to another tab and then switch back to the Network tab. You can see that the shared folder with the name you just set earlier is now available. Now I will proceed to install the software I have prepared. Now, to bring the Office icons onto the desktop, open the search bar and look for Word. Select Open File Location. Here, I will select the necessary icons and then copy them. Go to Drive C, then open the User folder. Select the Public folder. Here, select the View tab at the top, then choose Show Hidden Items. Select the Public Desktop folder. Then paste the icons here. Now access Drive C. Open Windows folder. Open System32 folder. Open Sysprep folder. Open Sysprep. Keep the selection and click OK. At this point, please press Ctrl-Shift-F3 to enter audit mode. Now we will delete the local account that was just created. Click the Windows icon and search for Control Panel. Select User Accounts. Select Manage Another Account. Click on the user you originally created and delete it. Now I will create a partition, right-click on the Windows icon and select Disk Management. Right-click on the C partition and select Shrink Volume. I will shrink about 40 gigabytes, so I will enter 40,960 megabytes. Right-click, select New Simple Volume. Set it to any letter you like. Name the volume as Data. That's it. The partition is done. Now go back to Sysprep, check the Generalize box, and select Reboot. When the computer restarts, keep pressing the F2 key repeatedly until the boot menu appears. Scroll down and select the SATA CD-ROM drive. Click Next, and then select the previous version of the setup. Click Repair Your Computer. Go to Troubleshoot. Select Command Prompt. Now I will open Notepad first to check my partition. Go to File, then Open. You can see that the drive containing Windows is C, and the 40 gigabytes data partition is D. Now I will edit the code to match the partition. The image file will be placed on drive D. And the partition to be captured will be C. You can give it a name here. And you can add a description if you want. Now I will copy the code and paste it into CMD. Go to Edit and select Paste. As you can see, I am getting a paste error, so copy in shorter segments to fix it. After succeeding, exit and select Continue to enter Windows. Now let's create a local account like before. Now let's reinstall VMware tools. Now I need to check if my shared folder is still working. You can see it is still working, and inside there is my Windows ISO file. Now we will download a free tool called AnyBurn. You can see that on drive D there is already the install.wim file I just captured. Now select Edit Image File. Select the ISO file in your shared folder. Go into the Sources folder. Find the install.wim file and delete it. Now click Add, then select the install.wim file we captured on drive D. Now rename your file. Click Create Now. So the custom Windows 11 ISO file has been successfully created, and you can see it in the shared folder on the host machine. Now you're going to check it. You can see that I already have the CUS file, so it's a success. Now I will connect it to the virtual machine and install it right away to show you a test run. So that's it. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel to support me and receive many more interesting videos about Windows. Have a great day.